Well, how you doing, everybody? Probably recognize that theme from the old Andy Griffith Show. And, always remember the scene with Andy and Opie walking along the riverbank as that theme song is being played. And the reason that sticks in my mind so vividly is somewhere I have a 8mm movie clip that my mother shot of my dad and I walking along the riverbank with our fishing poles, and it also is in black and white. So it's kind of a little fond memory of mine. Whenever I watch an old Andy Griffith Show episode and see that opening, it takes me back to that day with my dad and I. Anyway, what are we going to do today, and what does that have to do with take down your fishing pole and meet me at the fishing hole? Well, today we're going to cook some fish, and what we have is some nice Atlantic cod filets. And we're going to make baked cod parmesan. So, in preparation, you need to preheat your oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Pan with some parchment paper on it. A bowl. And we need to melt some butter. We can do that in high in the microwave. It'll take between, depending on your microwave, between 30 and 40 seconds to melt your butter. You're going to want a bowl, you're going to want a whisk. I forgot to get my whisk out. And my whisk is hiding. It got whisked away. There it is. We need our whisk. The other things you're going to need, you're going to need a quarter cup of butter, melted, which is what I'm doing. You're going to want a tablespoon of chopped parsley, a teaspoon of basil, 2 teaspoons of garlic powder, or if you prefer, you can use minced garlic, a tablespoon of lemon juice, grated parmesan, and some paprika. There we go, our butter is ready. So, we'll take our melted butter and pour it in our bowl. I'd bring the camera over so you could watch this, but I don't think you really need to see an up close of what I'm doing. It's pretty simple. If you need real strong instructions on pouring butter in a bowl, well, I don't know what to tell you. Okay, to the butter, you're going to add your lemon juice, your garlic powder, or your minced garlic, whichever you're using, your basil, and you're going to whisk that up. That's all there is to that. Then you want to take some paper towel, move these out of our way. Take your fish fillets. And just blot them with your paper towel to get any of the excess moisture off of them. As you can see, that's pretty wet, so they're pretty moist. And you don't want them dry, but you don't want them to be dripping wet either. Once you've done that, just run them through your mixture. And lay them on your parchment paper. This is a nice recipe. Your prep time is about 10 minutes, give or take. And your cooking time is about 15 to 18 minutes, depending on your oven. So there we go, that's that part done. Now, if you don't want to get your hands messy, you can use a pair of tongs to run your fish through the ingredients. Now, what we're going to do is we are going to dredge these with paprika. Too much. They don't need to be, you don't want to turn them into red snapper. You just want to dredge them a little bit with paprika. Spread Sprinkle some parsley flakes over the top. And finally, sprinkle on your Parmesan cheese. If you can get the lid open, there we go. There's the oven ready at 400 degrees, perfect timing. There we are, I'll just bring this over so you can have a little bit better look there. Don't want them to slide off on the floor, but that's what they'll look like before you put them in the oven. And now we're going to put them in the oven at 400 degrees for 15 minutes. Set our timer, 15 minutes. And there we go, they're off to the races. I'm not going to make you sit here and watch the oven for 15 minutes, so we'll be back in a blink of an eye. Well, our 15 minutes are up. Our cod is ready, so we'll get it out of the oven and plate it up. Now, one thing that does happen with fish as you cook it, you want to cook it till it flakes, for one thing, but sometimes it does shrink up a little bit. Glennis and I are going to have ours tonight with a nice salad. You could serve this with rice or potatoes or whatever you'd like. Well, there we have it. I'm going to put it on the table and get some pictures of it. Well, there we have it. On the table, set, fit for a king. It's got a little ambiance. Get that oil lamp going there. There we have it. A nice meal for two, easy to make, delicious, nutritious, and oh, by the way, if you're on a renal diet, this is also quite low in potassium. I hope you've enjoyed today's recipe, and I'll give it a try. Until Tuesday with Tuesdays with the Pilgrim, take care, stay safe, and God bless. Mm-hmm.